Okay, the fan sent me a gift certificate for the ceramic store, so I decided to invest a little more on the rolling blocks, roller, texture roller. So this is the three different patterns I added to my collection. I have three before, but now I have another three patterns. So I get to use the one of the pattern to see if I like the texture by using the rolling pressure to the surface of the cylinder. I showed it in my previous video. And this piece of clay is about 5-6 pounds. It's porcelain. A lot of people ask me now what kind of porcelain I use. I like the Coleman porcelain. It's good for throwing, but the temperature is a little bit low. I usually buy it to Cone 11, and the clay is not going to go to Cone 11. So I add a local clay. It's called Glacier. So I add about 2 to 1, 2 part of a Coleman and 1 part of Glacier. I mix them together. I have a pot meal. And that corrects the problem. I still have the nice translucent Coleman porcelain produced, but I could get to fire to Cone 11 without any problem. Basically, I'm adding the glacier to increase the temperature of the Coleman. So I'm just pulling the stress cylinder and make sure that my opening is not too big and it's not too small, so that I can put in the cardboard cylinder easily. Thank you. power cylinder. I already taped the newspaper. And this is from the badminton, the shadows that I use that. It's not too wide, and if you want to throw something that is skinnier, this is a good size to do that. So to put it on the inside and in the middle. I am just lightly squeezing, calling in, especially from the bottom, so that you don't trap the air from the bottom and gradually push up. It up all the way to the top, so the wall is fitting tightly, holding the cylinder inside. Okay, now since I'm going to roll the texture, I want the surface to be nice and smooth. So I am using the metal rib to get rid of my throwing mark. And also get rid of the slip. This is a slip that come from the surface. Slip coming off, but make sure you don't overdry it. If you overdry it, the cylinder is going to shrink more, and your cylinder, your carbo might not be able to pull it out because it's getting narrow and too tight. So this time I'm going to try this one. Okay, hold it on the top of the carpal and roll it up straight. Okay, I got a texture, roll it on the surface, and now I'm ready to pour out the cylinder. First, you pour out the cardboard, leave the newspaper inside. And now you get to pour out the newspaper. I have two layers of newspapers. So I pour one out and then pour another. That's the newspaper that is attached to the surface. So now I'm ready to stretch, but make sure when you stretch, because the inside is kind of dry, because all the slip has been absorbed by the newspaper, so you could add a little bit of water and a little bit of slip to the surface. So slowly start to stretch from the very bottom. So let me stop the wheel. You can see the movement. It was straight, but after I stretch, it's kind of like spiral up. So this is the finished piece. I don't know if I like the texture though. It's kind of like a dinosaur or crocodile surface. But at least I try using a different texture to create a surface to give you some idea. Okay, thanks for watching.